watching Fritz on Channel 6 and relaxing, feet cocked up, just a little with the cocktail and the pole attendant bill.
What you do?
I snatched him, took off through the air like a pigeon, quick so he won't start meowing and bitching. The lander at the cat tag addressed in the project.
Elevators broke,
so I have to take the back step.
Nah.
The doors opened and my eyes swole from the sad ass man tripping a quarter old gold.
Yo, is this the cat?
Oh, yes, where you find him at?
He was stuck in a tree about uptown Manhattan.
Well, how the hell did you save him? Are you police undercover?
Nah, baby, come on, the S of my chest stands for.
Come on,
broadcasting live from the entrance to historic Howard University, this is WLVS at Listen Vision Recording Studios, DC's number one recording studio, now streaming live on listenvision.com.
Do you have a hot single or want to promote your mixtape or album? Radio spins at WLVS Radio are only $75 per song for 50 spins throughout the month. That's right. We spin your song 50 times for only $75. Get your music heard at all 50 states and 135 countries. WLVS Radio is the largest online broadcaster in the United States. So what are you waiting for? Email your song and contact information to info@listenvision.com. That's info@listenvision.com. I'm Two-Face the Wild Boy, and I'll see you back here on Mondays, 1 to 3 p.m. on WLVS Radio. It's the Fix, baby.
They say I'm crazy, the way you got me open, baby. Ooh. They say I'm bugging, the way I'm time sweating your loving. Ooh. They all sit and wonder why this feeling I cannot hide. It ain't a question of pride. Ooh. It's love, love, love. Ooh. It's love, 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 love. They say I'm ripping the way you got my whole life flipping. Ooh. They say I'm
good morning, DMV and beyond. It's the Taylor Love Tales All Love's Tragic Comedy Show, and I'm all natural today. And of course, you know Wanda, my co-host.
Hello.
And do you remember Amari Black?
Yes.
She's Hello. Back. She's Yay. Doing some big things, and we'll share that with you later. But today, she is joining us for a roundtable on self-image. You know, some things I want to talk about: self-image, the way we look at ourselves, the way others perceive us, the way media presents us has a lot to do with the way we see ourselves. Do you
right.
agree, ladies?
Yes, definitely.
And a lot of yes. times it comes passed down from our parents as
yes.
well.
Parents, family, childhood, peers, the environment where you live,
right?
You know, yeah. what they perceive. So.
Because when I was growing up, I was bullied in elementary school because I had a big forehead and skinny legs and skinny arms. Well, I've grown into all of that now.
Okay.
Except
Everybody
for the
was awkward in elementary school. Everybody was different in elementary
yeah,
school.
Yeah, but you know, they, you know, certain kids highlight, you know, certain things, and sometimes you take that with you into adulthood.
Right. Yes.
And I still have an issue with my forehead, and Amari Black has pointed it out on several occasions that I should move
you
my eyebrows
bring it out.
Back here, and then I can have all this for eyeshadow space. But anyway.
Well, I think your forehead is actually shrinking.
Well,
the wiser you get, your forehead is shrinking, honey.
I got more knowledge filling yes. up and taking up that extra
So anyway, we're going to start with the good hair, bad hair debate. There is no bad hair. Let's just clear that up right now.
That nail. Used to be back in the day some good hair, bad hair. Come on, let's face it.
Good hair is when it's healthy.
Yes.
I agree. Nail. So what do y'all think about the good hair, bad hair debate? And Eric, if you could show pick A for me, please. We have Eric here today, so let's welcome Eric. He's going to be our engineer for today.
Welcome, Eric.
But see, we got the natural, we got the perm, the kind of kinky.
Right.
So, but like I said, if it's healthy and it looks good, it doesn't matter to me. You know, you may have your own personal preference of what you like or don't like. Mm-hmm. In the summer, I tend to like it wash and wear because it's easier because I like to swim. Eric, you can take that one off for us now. Thank you. And
On that note, like I said, back in the day, it was a difference. I was never raised or didn't know the difference pretty much, but I guess I was considered to have good hair because it was straight and long and curly, but I don't know how to work with it. I could not do my own hair. People said, well, dude, I can't do it. I could put in pigtails, ponytails. It depends on the person and their creativeness that they can, how they fix their hair. But nowadays, any woman has the option, even some that we would say, you don't need to add extensions because you were born with long hair, blonde hair, whatever. But you can have any option you want nowadays. Like you said, natural, if you want to add extensions, whatever you want to do is available to women. Even if you want to cut it real short, everything, I think, is stylish now.
And it's not just the black community.
Right.
You know, because Koreans, their hair is coarse, even though it looks pretty to us.
Right.
But with them, they have issues with it.
You can cut cheese with their hair.
Oh, yeah.
It's so sharp.
Right.
But a lot of it, like I said, stem from...
You
carry that crap that, you know, from childhood into adulthood and don't sometimes realize your own beauty.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
So, but anyway, so we're going to move on to some of the media events that highlighted the good hair, bad hair.
I just love my good hair today.
Well, I'm taking it home when I leave here.
Y'all noticed out there that my hair looks extra curly and longer. I mean, I just
and the color is amazing, darling.
So, you know, I can wonders for the complexion.
They done started something today.
Amari pimped you out a little bit this morning, but we'll see what the weekend holds.
Okay.
So, Eric, if you could show me the pick number B. And this is from school days. Y'all remember that was and it was, I forget
what. Tisha Campbell right there. I don't know the other. Mm-hmm.
Me neither, but I forget what
they. What were they called?
The Boogaboo.
And what was the light skin group name?
I forget.
I should have done
the Wannabes?
We're going to name them the Boogaboos.
If you know, call in. Let us know.
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Wanda. Mm-hmm. So, but it was and the natural looks good on her to me.
It does.
Yeah.
And Tisha Campbell had look a hot mess.
Right.
Yeah.
Just because it's straight don't mean it look good.
Okay.
So, anyway, thank you, Eric, for that picture. Eric, I'm going over there. We're going to sit on Eric's lap today. His girlfriend going to slap the crap out of us. And then another movie that, well, Chris Rock got into the whole debate as well, but he tried to bring the story to light about how we got to the point of good hair, bad hair. So he was trying to say all hair is good hair as well. So if you could show us that from Chris Rock, that would be pick number C. But look,
that little girl
putting a perm in her head. That is ridiculous. And so she will probably never in life go without a perm unless she comes beyond
that. Now, what is the age that she's too young for a perm?
Under 16.
I say after you graduate, 18.
To get a perm. You know that ain't going to be happening. No.
They're
from kindergarten. They got to get their hair done, honey.
But if it was my daughter, you can get a perm and all of that when you go to your prom for senior high school.
I know it was me.
But my kids will probably had good hair, so.
Okay.
I know it was me following the crowd. I put perm in my hair, and I went with perm, like, for so many years. And then just recently, this year, I decided I'm going to go natural. And I finally saw what my natural hair actually looked like, you know?
You have nice tresses as well. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, but even if your child has more coarse hair, you need to let them embrace that.
Mm-hmm.
Baby, you know, people are trying to get that kind of hair. Mm-hmm. You know, not take them and put a damn perm in it.
Right.
You know, fix it up, put a little bow in it. But they look so cute sometimes. I like the puff balls.
Yeah.
So anyway, where are my glasses? I feel like I'm racing this morning. The next thing I want to talk about is let's show Al Sharpton and pick D.
Oh, my goodness. That's my man now.
Oh, my goodness. But Al, when I was reading the Rejected Stone, Wanda and I are both reading that, he talked about why he had that perm,
mm-hmm.
and it's because James Brown was his idol
mm-hmm.
and encouraged him to dress
perm it out
and look like him. So, you know, when we take on people that we idolize, then we sometimes start to emulate them, whether it be in a bad or a good way. But that wasn't a good look for either of them.
Oh my God, look how big, heavy he was.
A lot of men back in the day, 60s, with
Billy D.
Their hair, Billy D, Temptations. Mm-hmm. What was that movie, that Five Heartbeats, when he had to get a perm and it was burning him and he jumped because the water was coming and put his head in the toilet and everything. So, yeah, it's just something that I think that was handed down to the African-American people for some reason didn't embrace the hair thing. I mean, who was the first person to tell somebody, you need to put a perm
in it?
What
was the lady that did the, Black History Month?
Madam C.J. Walker.
Thank you.
So, back in the day, you know, even before, you know, way back with our grandparents, they were trying to blend in. They were trying to emulate.
Mm-hmm.
And
exactly.
And so in order to do that and to try and cross
over.
Cross over, they started straightening their hair.
Yeah.
But if your skin was dark, you still weren't crossing.
Yeah, but your hair was straight.
Yeah. So we're going to get into
Back then, if you was white, I mean, bright.
We're crossing over into the light skin, dark skin debate now. So we can see pick E, which is our boo boo Michael Jackson.
Oh.
So, you know, that light skin, dark skin, that's another thing that some of our parents have passed down to us. Especially if you had children, some were lighter, some were darker.
Mm-hmm.
Then they sometimes favored the light skin ones, and my mother was telling me a story about my grandmother who was fair skinned, and she would try and pass. You know, you go to the market, you ain't got to stand in the back, you can get the fresh bread.
Right.
And then they say, well,
what is she?
You got a tan?
Okay,
it's winter time.
Yeah, I went to Florida.
So even with the light skin, dark skin thing, I don't have that. I haven't grown up with that issue, but I know people who have, and they use those skin lightening creams and whatever else, cake on the light makeup.
Right.
And then, you know, why? For what?
The image, you know, just like the hair and stuff. But I've never experienced that growing up. I have a whole, like, rainbow, my grandfather used to say. The African-American culture has a rainbow of people. It's so pretty. We could go from all shades and whatever, and it's beautiful, but we still don't embrace it. But my kids,
French
I call
vanilla.
Them the deeper kids. I have one that's browner than the other. One's light and one's, I ain't going to say dark, because she'd be like, what? But she's Coco Chocolate. Love you, boo.
Yeah.
But, so it depends on your genes and your DNA. You can reach back and get something to come back, and you be like, and he'd be like, that ain't my baby. Like, look, we should have checked the DNA before we did this, okay? Because you don't know what you're going to get, no surprise packages.
And black is definitely beautiful.
Yes,
and
it
so,
is.
And so, you know, and we're going to speak to the Caucasians as well, because they tan all year round.
Mm-hmm. But I have to say this. Coming here today, I was driving, and I saw somebody walking ahead on shorts. And the legs were, like, pink red.
So I thought she had some leggings under the shorts, but those were her actual color of her
Honey,
legs.
Honey, she running to the tanning booth right now.
Yeah, so she was running somewhere.
Well, Wanda brought to my attention when we were talking about tanning, the tanning mom, which is pick F for us, Eric. So the tanning mom, you know the story, Wanda? Or you
yes, know? I know the story.
Addiction.
Look at that. Look at,
that's terrible.
So tell us the story.
The story is, I believe she lives in New Jersey.
Correct.
And she has an obsession with tanning, what some people do. I mean, hey, I would like a little color in the winter. You know, I get more color in the summer, but in the winter I get a little pale. So I would like a little bit more color, but I don't know if I want to be closed in this waffle iron to get the color. But, yeah, so this lady, you know, is obsessed with, I think her daughter was 16-ish, something of mid-teens, and she said, oh, get a tan, you know, this. So she took, no, she must have been younger than that, because she took her to the salon to get a tanning thing, and it was an issue
about
her age.
Right.
So, it was an issue about her age, so it got to go to the court. I mean, a whole big spiel about she took her daughter to get a tan.
Eric, you can take the tanning mom down there. It's making me want a chocolate bar.
Yeah. So anyway, that was the story. So that's another thing. What age is too young to get going to the tanning salon?
You have to be an adult to go into a tanning salon. Yeah. You got to be ready to take on skin cancer and some more stuff.
Well,
risk involved.
Yeah.
Right. So my child, I'm not signing no waiver, no authorization form or nothing for my child to go to a tanning salon. And even when they go outside, we put that SPF 50-30 on our kids to protect them. And with African Americans, because we have more melatonin in our system, we don't, we can still get cancer,
right,
but
right.
the risk is less. So thank you, African Americans, Africans, for we got a plus on that.
Right.
And we don't burn as readily either, and our skin tends to stay more supple, even though when we get more sun, where there's other nationalities seem to, you know, crack a little bit.
Yeah. Okay.
So now we're going to talk.
Black don't crack.
You better get that. All right. Now we're going to talk about facial features. Nose, lips, contact lens, eye colors. So if we can see little Kim, pick number G, Eric. Look at all the different. Yes. And to me,
the first one.
Yeah, when she was natural is the best.
Yeah.
What you doing, little Kim? Now you look like you.
What is she doing now, little Kim?
She's still not happy.
Yeah,
right. Now she got to correct.
Yeah.
Now
she looks like that white lady.
Asian.
On the end, Asian, but her cheeks look like somebody. I can't think of who that person
is. First, I was saying Janet Jackson. Mixed with Lisa Ling and
Kim Kumar.
So, but anyway, she was so cute when she was natural. And
right. But she, her dress style.
Thank you, Eric.
That's another show.
So people have this obsession with their nose, that thinner is better. And we were talking about contouring and making your nose look thinner. Wendy Williams says she like a man with a big nose, though.
Okay, well, that's the man.
Okay. And then we have the lips. You know, we went from having people wanting super thin lips, and now we got the Botox, and now the lips are all puckered
right.
up. They have makeup that has lip puckering in it, and all of that, and then there's the contact lenses.
Well, I would like to have bigger lips, a little bit more.
Yeah, I would like
a little puffier.
A little fuller.
Yeah.
A little fuller.
Yeah.
I'm happy with my nose and my. I'm still stuck on my
forehead. I'm happy with my nose. Back in the day, I was not. You know, people teased me, and you know, it carried on. And at one point, I had sort of considered having a nose job done. And I was like. I was thinking about the pain.
Let me tell you something about Amari Black. She can analyze some shit to death.
Yeah, I don't just see what's going on right now, and I see the future and all that.
Yeah.
But today, I'm happy with me.
Great.
And,
good.
And that's my dad. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So he lives
within you. So, but with the contact lens, I know, like, back in, you know, still back in the day, you had light eyes. Ooh, you got light eyes. I'm going to get a baby with him.
Right.
That curly head, light skin, light eyes.
Anything that was different out of the norm.
Yeah.
Out of our community's norm, that's tended to be, well, he must be half white. Well, I think it was Cherokee and Indian back in my day.
Yeah, the Indian. You got Indian in you.
Puerto Rican.
Now I got Puerto Rican in you. Yeah.
Dominican and all of that. So, in terms of contacts, if I could put them in, I probably would wear different colors. But I would never try and
make pretend as if
they're mine.
Right.
And so, you know, with that.
What color would you get?
I'd probably get a lighter brown than my actual eye color.
Actually, the brown is like popping brown.
Oh, that's
right, because
it doesn't look natural.
But I mean, I wear gray sometimes, and it's just to accessorize.
You got them on
not to, no.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because when it crosses over when it becomes an obsession versus an accessory.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, when you just cannot leave the house without all
everything
this, right
together,
then I think you're crossing over and having.
I wish I was like that.
What?
I wish I could leave the house and be totally, you know, together.
Put together.
All
that's
the
so
time.
Much damn
all
work.
The time.
Work.
It is.
What about
but
my
life? I never developed that. So.
Me neither. I don't have the patience or the wherewithal or the finances to do all of that. And plus, this damn wig shit is hot, and I can't wait till the break.
Okay. Are we going to take over?
Hell yeah.
I'm loving my locks right now.
I know. I'm taking mine off. I hope. Where's the comb? You got it ready for me?
Well, it's
okay.
We'll get it later.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So moving on.
Yep. Moving on.
Breast augmentation. And so we're going to show Pick H, who is Pamela Anderson. Wow. I mean, even.
She got bigger.
Wow. Yeah, I think she grew. They were flatter before. Then 2001, she got that size. And in 2008, she had that size. I don't know what size they
but
are.
But it looks like they spread apart.
Well,
I wonder what they feel like.
Heavy.
They heavy? Okay.
Like you carry
around. Are they hard?
If they silicone,
is soft.
Yeah, it's like a fluid inside of a plastic bubble.
Saline water.
Yeah. So anyway, I like my breast size now, but back in the day, I was like a triple A.
Oh, Lord.
I can't believe that.
I was putting socks in my bras.
Yeah, because
I want them. But now, I like my size now.
So you're growing to them now.
Yeah.
But they grew with you.
Wouldn't get any other breast augmentation.
No, I don't think I have.
Yeah. And let's see, pick out. Eric, who is Wendy Williams, and she always talks about her girls.
She does. Yeah. Oh, you found her way before. Okay.
Uh-huh. And she was a nice size then.
Yeah.
And she's overkill. Men don't even really care for that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, they like to look at it
and lust
over it.
Right.
Woman, they don't want to. Being big with that
every night. But I want a big jugs like that so I can shake it in their face. Like, boop, boop,
and then you
want
to sit them to the side when you're done?
Slap them back. Okay.
And she says that, you know, when you do get those breast augmentations, they require maintenance too.
Yeah, right. She goes every 5 years.
Yeah,
to
who's
get
got
them,
2,000?
Pump up the silicone back in there and all that.
That's what the Victoria's Secret.
That's what those are for.
Oh, really?
The Wonder Bra.
Yeah, Wonder Bra.
Oh, yeah. Because they give you lift and they have a little cushion in them.
Yeah.
See, lady? Mm-hmm. All right. Now, I don't know if you guys have heard about this new phenomenon called thigh gap, where women are trying to picture Jay for us, please, Eric. Women are trying to have this thigh gap, and so Dr. Oz last week had a woman
on there. What the hell is that right there, skinny? Look at
that, and
the
leg
bones.
You have to damn near be anorexic.
Well, she looking.
Yeah, and the lady that was on Dr. Oz, who was an African American, she was perpetuating this diet. Thank you, Eric, to get thigh gap, and she just looks sickly.
I always thought thigh gap mean that she was a hooker.
Right.
Well, you know, when you
right.
got a gap,
right. Yeah, a whole bunch of people be getting
yeah,
up in there.
But
right.
now it's a style.
Yeah, right.
So what, I mean, are you exercising or
they're dieting to the point of starving themselves to get rid of the meat.
Wow. But isn't there an exercise with this little clamp thing?
Yeah, that'll tighten it, but I ain't going to give you
oh,
that
give
look.
You the, give you the tunnel look. Got the damn Baltimore Harbor Tunnel look.
I mean, lifting your breast, your butt, all that require exercise.
Yeah.
You
right.
want to do it naturally.
Yeah.
Right.
You know?
Exactly. And so now we're moving on down the body, as you guys can see.
Mm.
Now, well, we're going to get to the stomach because, you know, we ladies sometimes have an issue with their stomach, but we ain't going to talk about spanks today. So we're going to move on down to the obsession with the big booty. First, it started out, again, when Flat was in. You know, you
Flat was
right.
in.
That was
I wish
great.
That would come back in.
Yeah, because we'd be popular. Well, I'd be popular.
And me too. Yeah, we'd be popular.
Now, all of a sudden, I don't know if it was J-Lo or who came out with the
thing was J-Lo.
When everybody said, oh.
No, Thelma had a little round cush, but see,
some
good times.
But nobody was tripping over Thelma. The whole world didn't change. The white people didn't come out and say, I want a big booty.
Well, not with Thelma, no. No, it might have been with J-Lo. Maybe J-Lo.
The thing is, when Caucasians pick up something, it becomes a damn trend, like they invented it.
Yeah.
We had big asses.
Oh, yeah.
You know, years ago.
Yeah.
The
mammies in the house.
Eric.
You know, had to have that butt to carry the kids.
I know. We're not talking about
house,
your
you
butt,
know.
Eric.
Put you on your hips
right.
and all that.
But when they do something, it's the hottest thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's the new trend. Mm-hmm. When they want to tan, dark is in. When they want dreads are in.
Yeah, lips.
When they get extensions, they got a whole new program. Mm-hmm. We've been doing extensions for years. And now, I think it was, like I said, J-Lo, who I think first brought the big booty on the scene, and then everybody wanted to get a big
jumping
booty.
On, yeah.
So, now I want, and so we get booty poppers, and that's okay.
Yeah.
They're kind of natural. Fill your jeans out.
Yeah. I always think one pad is up and one is down, and my cheeks don't look even. So the booty popper pads could just have, like, suck on your back of your cheeks and everything stay in place.
I will tell you my two booty popper experiences.
Okay.
And I think you already know, Amari. I had some booty poppers. But I wanted to put them in a different pair of underwear. So I said to myself, what about two-sided Velcro? So I stuck the Velcro on the silicone so they could stick to the underwear. But it created this long line that you could see through my dress.
Oh!
And then I couldn't get the two-sided Velcro off, so now I couldn't use those silicone things anymore. So then I had another thing where I said I had some more inserts.
With the long line of your Velcro strip?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
She
okay.
on the wrong side.
Oh.
Yeah, the side because she wanted it to stick to the clothing.
Oh.
It was just a hot mess.
Okay.
So then I had some more inserts, and I said, I'm just going to put them in my regular underwear.
Okay.
Because if you don't know, usually the booty poppers, some of them have pockets where you
right.
sit the stuff.
Right, right. Yeah.
So I said, I'm going to just put them in regular underwear, some nice tight ones. By the time I got to work, that thing had worked its way out of the bottom of my panty and was now, like, at the top of my kneecap. And I'm getting off the train holding one booty popper so it wouldn't fall out the bottom of my dick. So then I got to just threw it in the drawer.
I'm going to tell you all about an incident that I had. It must be my my water. My
your water, your true serum water.
But, I had some silicones in my swimwear.
Oh.
It was the shorts that you
wear.
That's what I was looking cute. And I was going down, going on one of the rides down in the tube. Right?
Uh-huh.
When I got to the end of the tube, I'm like, uh-oh. So my butt was lopsided.
You had one
I was like, oh, my goodness.
So
ladies, so you left it on the slide. You went crawling up the slide to get that. Oh, tell the little kid, when you come down, can you look for a pad on the way there?
I'm like, what kind of pad?
So ladies, if you wear the booty poppers, make sure they're secure.
Yes.
And then I want to talk about now the injections, which is all the rage. They have plumping parties, which are not federally regulated, nor are the materials used to inject people. The way, if you wanted to get injections for your booty, the proper way is to have the fat sucked out of your tummy, and then it is injected into your behind. That's the only right now federally regulated and approved way to do that. But we're going to talk about Nicki Minaj. Pick K for me, Eric.
With all of these, it's like they just go overboard.
Yeah, and yeah. You know, that was her before. And that's her.
Oh, yeah, she was right. Cute
yeah.
Before.
Yeah. She has gone over the top.
And
then I say, what are you going to do when you're 50? Or 30.
Inflated.
But I want to show you, pick L, Eric, because we are almost to the next segment of the show. This is...
Oh, my.
Is that her?
That's
not Nicki Minaj.
This is Pebbles the Model.
Oh, wow.
Pebbles the Model, I think they said her circumference or whatever is 42 or 52 inches round.
But see, some of those people, they do that because that's their moneymaker. You know, they
probably...
Yeah,
right,
and
yeah.
I say she's a porn star.
You know, but after you...
I wonder if she can make it clap.
Oh, my God. That thing probably won't... If she bounced on it, it probably hit the floor like a basketball and popped back up.
Oh, that ball that they had, that rubber
ball. But she is now up for charges for manslaughter because she injected... I think she's in Philadelphia. She injected a lady with concrete and the woman died.
Wow.
Her ass is concrete.
No.
Oh, okay.
She probably tried to make a quick dollar and shot this lady up with some concrete. Or it may have been somebody she didn't like. I don't know the particular story about why she did it. But the woman ended up dying. So Pebbles the Model and her girlfriend are both up for manslaughter charges.
Is that the woman that was going around to different hotels and was... injecting
more,
that's something different.
I'm not sure. So many of them going
right, yeah.
Now that it's just crazy.
Yeah.
So, ladies, you know, all of the
careful.
Right. And the plumping parties, you know, you don't know what you're getting shot up with.
Yeah.
You know, and Atlanta, you know, all the love of hip hop and all of that.
Housewives.
Right. Everybody got their booty popped up. New York, everybody's got the injections because, Nyla Lee on Love and Hip Hop New York was talking about how she had gotten injections, and she has a girl that does hers.
Mm.
But she didn't, you know, she wasn't going to tell us on TV who that was. And that when people come to her to see her girl, she never recommends it because she doesn't know how the outcome is
right.
going to happen. And she was talking about Pebbles the Model and how she's not going to be caught up in murder charges just to refer somebody. So
you get a big ass.
Right.
You going to be like, what you in here for? I shot somebody up in the butt.
Okay. All right. And now, Eric, if you could show us pick M. And that's Pam Grier Wanda. Love Pam Grier. She's a natural beauty.
Yeah. Natural. This is...
This is black beauty at its best.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
I mean,
so,
we all
beautiful,
but she was one of those pioneers and, you know, blazed the trail for us and made, because a lot of times back then, too, the men didn't want black women to look sexy.
Mm-hmm.
They want you to look all frumpy inside, but they want to chase the harlot down the street.
Right.
Where they run their numbers or whatever.
Right.
Right.
You know, at the
running
bar,
numbers.
In the brothel,
uh-huh.
But Pam Grier made it okay for us to, you know, accentuate our body, accentuate our look, and feel good about who we are. So, kudos to you, Pam Grier.
Yep. Foxy Brown.
So, what I want to say is you got to know the difference between enhancements and obsession.
Right.
And you have to learn to love the skin you're in because you can change the outside.
Mm-hmm.
But if you,
if
you feel a certain type of way on the inside, nothing you do
will work.
So with that being said, we're getting ready to go to break, and we're having a new segment, and it's called Sponsor Showcase. And our first sponsor for the Tale of Love Tales All Love's Tragic Comedy Show is Amari Black, and she's going to talk about unique products. And so she left the Taylor Love team to pursue her career and some of her endeavors, and we support her, and she's still part of the family. So if you give us a moment, don't go anywhere. And also, you guys out there, if you want to be a sponsor on the Taylor Love Show, this would be the segment where you would be placed. So if you want to be a sponsor, hit us up, TaylorLoveTalesAll@gmail.com, or you can call me, 202-329-0219, and we have a place for you right here on the Taylor Love Tales All Love's Tragic Comedy Show. So, Eric, if you could take us to break with Maze, Frankie Beverly and Maze Thankful, and we'll be back in a sec. Hello, this is Taylor Love Tales All Love's Tragic Comedy Show, and we are back with our sponsor showcase. Amari Black is going to talk to you about unique products and the unique product line, and probably give us a little demonstration on Wanda. So, take the floor, Amari.
Well, I want to say thank you all for having me here.
Always.
It's been a pleasure. I'm now with Unique Cosmetics, which is a natural-based cosmetic company. We launched in October 2012.
Hold up 1 second, please. Eric, if you could turn that down a little bit, please. Thank you, sweetie. Go ahead.
Like I said, we're Unique Cosmetics, and it's a natural-based cosmetic company. We've launched in 2012 and have reached record-breaking numbers since that time. I'm going to get into what our number one product is a little later. But this is a very amazing company. All of our products are natural ingredients, vegan and gluten-free.
Oh, I can eat them?
No, I wouldn't.
Right, I'm hungry.
Our motto is to uplift, empower, and to motivate women.
Okay. Which is very apropos for Women's History Month.
Right. And if you was to go on the website, we also list all of the ingredients. We give you a little information on all the ingredients, you know, so you'll know, you'll be able to make an informative decision.
Okay.
In, you know, what you're using. Everybody's trying to go natural now.
Right.
You know, so they care.
Go green.
Eating as well as what they're putting on their skin and, you know.
Bless you.
I have a couple books here that I'm just going to pass to you all if y'all just want to browse through it.
Thank you.
I guess you can go to your next.
You ready for your next pick?
Yeah.
Which is pick number. Thank you.
Yeah, that's pretty. Yeah.
Isn't that beautiful?
That's the Moonstruck pigment powders. Very vibrant colors. We have shimmer and matte finishes.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people compare it to our products to. Bare Mineral.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
And, but I've tried a lot of different products, you know, and this is a very wonderful product that it lasts for like hours without cracking.
Right. So those creases.
Fading away.
Right.
Uh-huh.
And people are always talking about putting the
primer
up under it. And with this, I've tried it one day to see exactly how long I can go without it cracking and creasing. And it was actually 10 hours and still with no crease.
Like I told you, she's amazing on the research. All right, thank you. You could move that,
research.
Take that picture down for us.
Over 30 different colors that you can select from.
Okay. And what's next on your list?
And this is a sample of all the different colors that we have here.
Okay.
Actually, this is a... presenter's package.
Okay.
With all the different sample colors, you know, so if you want to be a presenter, you can always get all those where you can sample them.
Uh-huh.
All they want. Okay, so
Our next picture is Amari.
Oh, the Moonstruck. I thought you were going to show it. Oh, this is the before and after.
Right.
Of our Moonstruck 3D Fiber Lash Mascara. Now, that is some amazing stuff.
Oh, yes, and she's done a demonstration on me. And, I mean, the lash just grows and grows and grows before your eyes. So it's really amazing.
Does it have a material that makes your lashes healthier and grow?
Okay, thank you, Eric.
That medical mascara... Did you go to the dermatologist to get to make your lashes grow? I forgot the name.
Oh, Latisse.
I've tried it. This is instant growth, but of course you wash it off daily.
Okay.
Yeah. And it comes in this pretty little kit here, pretty little case.
Mm-hmm.
It's a two-part system. It has the transparent gel as well as the fiber. And this is natural fibers. The fibers are made with green tea leaves. Like I said, everything is coming with natural products.
And then how do you apply? You put the primer on
first. You saturate your lashes, and then you put a layer of the fiber.
On top.
You let it lay there, and then you seal it with the gel.
Okay. So the three-part process.
Three steps.
And if you want it longer, I normally apply it twice.
Okay.
And in March the 15th, we have a new they redesigned the gel formula, and to where you would apply it twice. If you apply it one time, that would be the length of applying it. Time.
Oh, so they're going to be, right, without having to do the process as long.
Right.
Okay, and let's move on down to our lip sweetheart. Eric, if you could show us the lips, please.
All right.
Tell us about,
those
are Amari Black's lips.
All right.
It's a lucrative lip gloss.
Wanna put it on them lips like,
wearing lavish there. That's another amazing product.
Thank you, Eric. And which one is this? What is this one?
This one is...
Because I'm trying to get a red that you were going to be looking for me.
This is the lavish that I had on.
And they do have neutrals, so those are pretty,
this
too.
This is a very neutral color. I love this. This is lovable, and that's what I'm wearing today.
Oh, she's lovable.
Black?
No, black.
Blue lips,
no.
Black blue lips, no.
Just red, orange, natural color.
Okay.
Yeah. And this is another amazing product. And I've had people ask me, what is different with our lip gloss versus some other ones?
Mm-hmm.
For one, is natural products. And another one, and a lot of times the lip gloss is sticky.
Right. Oh, yeah.
It's just creamy.
And I'm not going to talk about who got the sticky lip gloss.
Wonderful on the lips.
All right, so tell us where we can find out more about your products and where people can reach you.
Yeah, you can log on to my website, www.uniqueproducts.com, at Amari Black. Amari Black is spelled A-M-A-R-I Black, B-L-A-C-K. You can also follow me on Facebook. That's www.facebook.com/ Amari Black. TP, T as in Tom, P as in Paul, and that's
Trading Post. Yeah, AB Trading Post.
Yeah,
coming out, yeah. Right, and we will be sharing all her information. You can always hit me up to get more information. Find me if you can't find her. We all stay connected through social media, and please support her and her endeavors as she has supported us and ours. And so with that being said, we're getting ready to go to Let's Talk with Wanda segment. So one more short break. I know y'all's attention span is very short, but Eric, if you could take us to break with Rufus and Chaka Khan, so we can set up for the next segment of Let's Talk. Tragic comedy, and we are here with Wanda so she can do her segment. Let's Talk with Wanda. Yes, hello. Hope everyone had a great week. We made it through the snowstorm, what number? 999.
And it made up for last year.
Yeah, right. And the sun's out today and it's nice and warm.
Let me just say, prayer works, people, because I was praying for a blizzard all last year. Y'all remember?
Yeah.
So I got my snow.
You got your blizzard, yeah.
So thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I know everybody else wasn't in
it. Now we're praying for sunshine, warmer weather, so we can get out.
Okay.
So this week was kind of busy for us and all. A lot of things were going on. I happened to go out on Thursday to meet my friend Steve and some other friends of his. So I got to meet some interesting people. Donita, and it was her birthday is coming up March 22nd.
Happy birthday.
And she's also getting married, and their friends Diamond and Jasmine as well. So we had a great time at Society. Got to meet the owners, giving them their shout-outs to Jason and Stephanie. So we are planning to do maybe a meet-and-greet there so you can come and see Taylor Love Tales all at the Society in Silver Spring on Georgia Avenue.
And that's such a cool venue, too. It's so artsy-fartsy.
Yeah.
I like that place. So
yeah. They had a band, but I didn't get the name of the band.
So hopefully we'll be hanging out there soon, too.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yes, and then we went to Art Night with Dyke was last night. Dyke, the artist,
the artistic
icon.
One.
The artistic one.
I named him Dyke the artist icon,
right.
But it's actually Dyke, the artistic one.
Oh, okay.
So
we was with Dyke last night at the art exhibit at the New Coffee House on Kennedy Street. And the name of that coffee house was?
Called Culture Coffee.
Culture Coffee on Kennedy Street, 709 Kennedy Street, Northwest.
And Culture Coffee just opened November 2nd. And what she does is open her doors to the community, the African American community first and foremost. But anybody who has some artistic ability or just wants to come and network. But she has like open mic night, poetry readings, music, and like she sponsors local artists in the community.
Right.
So it's a small coffee shop. It's very quaint. The owners are Chandrell and Veronica, two young ladies, and they were very nice, all different kinds of coffees and teas. So please go out and support, you know, different venues in your community as well. And we'll be doing some more things from Culture Coffee at 709 Kennedy Street, Northwest as well.
Yes, and they also have vegan dishes, vegetarian dishes. So if you feel like a little cup of joe and a
veggie sandwich,
yeah, this is the place to go.
But no alcoholic beverages. So.
No.
No Sambuca in your coffee, so drink at home and then wander in for your coffee.
Right.
What else you got there?
So, okay, on the entertainment stuff this week is going on, Nene Leakes is going to be with Dancing with the Stars.
Really? I thought she was there before. What? Who was it?
No.
Sherry Shepherd,
Wendy Williams.
Oh, that's
yeah. So you might think Wendy Williams and Nene because about the same height.
But
so she's going to be on Dancing with the Stars. So that's going to be interesting to see if Nene can dance as well as she runs her mouth, okay?
Right.
And also Billy Dee is still around, so we're going to see what he does. Yes, Billy Dee.
Are they going to be on the same show?
Yes, the same show.
Oh, well, then I'm tuning in because typically I don't tune in to that show because I don't know who's who. I don't know who's the dancer and who's the star. But, yeah, I'm going to be watching that.
Yeah. And so also on the news this week was Pharrell with his famous hat that he wore at the Emmys, I believe. He had this old brown, remind me of like the Beverly Hillbillies, Uncle Jed. That had
of the Smokey the Bear.
Yeah. So Arby's restaurant purchased the hat for a donation. The hat went for $44,100. Which is not a lot, but it is for this ugly-looking hat.
I mean,
because
people
that's
buy
their
some
symbol.
Stuff, won't they?
Yeah, so that's how Pharrell did that. And also, I heard some terrible news in Annapolis about a pregnant lady was robbed at gunpoint in Annapolis for them to steal her car. She's walking out with her, I'm going to say husband, but now it might have been her baby father, neighbor, whoever. But they were going to take her to the hospital, and these two guys came up.
Yeah, she was in
labor. Yeah, she was in labor.
Right.
And these two crazy guys come up to a gunpoint, a shotgun, and wanted the car. So the boyfriend left her to go get help. She's in labor. The guys are there at the car. Just craziness. But she made it to the hospital. Hopefully she went through labor. The baby's okay.
Everything did.
But
so.
I mean, come on now. We
didn't y'all see she was pregnant?
Yeah. The water is dripping out. The water's breaking. You know, so.
But why did he run?
Yeah, right. Left her there. So anyway. And also, as you know, Taylor Love Tells All is doing Women's History Month this month of March. So today on the mall, they have the Women's International Day. So if it's a nice day and you want to do something, walk around, get some exercise, get some information on women's information, well, you can go down to the mall to get some information on International Women's Day down on the mall. And also today is also the Unplug Day.
Oh, that's right. We're supposed to turn our cell phones off.
So, but don't turn it off until you finish with Taylor Love Tales Off.
And I upload the video tonight on YouTube.
Right.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Taylor Love Tales Off.
Okay. And so what else do I have here?
I got to put my glasses on.
But let's give a great acknowledgement to another African-American Oscar winner, which was Lupita Nyong'o. So Lupita, shout out to you, dear.
She
you look
beautiful.
We did great that we're discussing you on self-image. You are so comfortable in your own skin. You did a great job. 12 Years a Slave is playing Patsy.
Oh, my
Your
goodness.
Speech was wonderful.
Yeah.
And so props to you, girl. Go for it and hope to see you again on the big screen in all kinds of roles, just not anything painful. Why do we always get roles for painful experiences? Like Halle Berry did Monster Ball. She did
Precious.
Yeah, Precious. And then the first lady did Gone with the Wind, Hattie McDaniel, I think, was the first Oscar winner.
I want to see crime solver.
Yeah, or...
I like mysteries.
Just giving love there, but why we got to be broken down? But anyway, so props to you, LaPita.
And she uses avocado oil on her skin daily.
Oh, okay.
Didn't you see how beautiful it was and flawless?
Does she squeeze it out, the avocado, or she
scoops
it and rub it on?
I don't know.
How do you get the oil separated?
I'm sure she got somebody doing it
for
her.
Oh, yeah, I know she
Somebody back there start squeezing some avocado. Avocados,
right.
All right.
And for some people, this might be very interesting. DC just passed the pot bill.
Oh.
So it's no longer where they smell marijuana, they can pull you over for the assumption that you have a whole whatever bag full in the back of your trunk. But they have to actually see you smoking it. And if they do catch you, it's a $25
right.
fine. And it's not a major crime charge. Right. So misdemeanor, you know, because I guess they're getting tired of writing all these damn tickets
right.
and taking
Going
you to the
and like
station.
They said, it's mostly in the black community.
Yeah.
Everybody up in Georgetown.
Yeah, smokes freely.
Right.
Yeah, so this is a big plus, and especially, not to say we should be doing it,
right.
but, you know, I hear it helps with some medical issues that people have.
All right, Wanda, we have 5 minutes, so let's
okay.
go to our event.
Yeah.
Because today, what we doing?
Today, we are going to the self-image.
She don't have, yeah, she's like, where's my flyer?
Yeah.
We are going to the Women's Collective.
Yeah, the Women's Collective today.
And that's on Rhode Island Avenue.
Come out.
And they're doing an all-day seminar for mothers and daughters on self-image, HIV.
Testing
and education. We're going to get our test today.
Yeah.
And you can get your results in 20 minutes. Women's Collective supports women who are HIV AIDS positive, you know, with jobs, medical, housing. So if you get a chance, go on their website, Women's Collective, and see what you can do to help those in need. So immediately leaving here, we're going there.
Rhode Island Avenue.
Right.
So, and also, next week we will be re-airing the Women's Collective, so you can see a little bit more what they're doing
right.
with their center and everything. Great information. We will be in Raleigh, North Carolina at the Women's Empowerment event with Tyler Perry's the guest speaker. So we're going to bring all that great information back to you on the 22nd. So tune in on the 15th anyway, so in case you
right.
missed the show. And then on March 27th, Usani's House Fashion Show, which is coming up, and we're looking so forward to that.
And last week I said it was free. It is not free. It is $15, which is still minimal.
Great.
And it's still open bar.
Oh, but shouldn't you can pay $15 for a show and open bar.
Yeah, and she is highlighting the diversity of the District of Columbia by using rare beads, stones, and minerals in her jewelry. So come out and support Chrissy Taylor at the former Usani House Fashion Show. And it is at the
Hamiltonian
Art Gallery at 1353 U Street Northwest. And for artists out there that are looking for space, go onto their website, Hamiltonian Art Gallery. They have some
Yeah, stuff. It looks great.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
The
we
venue
might be having
is just
something
amazing
here.
There. So go out and support. And we have like 2 minutes to give kisses. And
yep. Oh, I want to say happy, happy, happy birthday to my beautiful daughter. Her
yeah,
birthday is tomorrow.
Casey, happy
so
birthday.
Happy birthday. I love you, honey.
And so that's the end of our show for today.
Yep.
And it went well. And you see, we came out of, we're natural.
Yeah, we're
natural.
But I like that, the fullness with that wig.
Mine was hot.
Okay.
So anyway, we love you guys for tuning in. Don't forget, follow me on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, you know where to find me anyway.
And welcome, Mari. It was nice having
you
today.
Yes, thank you for coming out. And Eric, we are ready to go. And thank you so much for working with us today. And smooches, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Have a blessed week.
How dare you call that real hip hop? Put a mic down your throat, make your jaw lock, go off the top.